What's your favorite techno right now?
Grimes.
Hey. Hey.
I feel like there's so many random things we've both done that no one else has done.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, like the avatars and like, that. I mean, that was one of my favorite things ever when I saw that you guys were each had sort of like, your digital.
Yeah.
Are they called like the AI or the AE?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah, yeah.
It's
okay.
Called the I, like I winter, I Ningning.
Yeah. I read a lot. I don't see much said out loud. So I'm one of those people that will mispronounce everything. But,
oh, no, that's fun. Us too.
But yeah, no, I think it's really interesting that like we both kind of did it around the same time, and I always just sort of felt a kinship in that you guys were doing that, and I also feel like because a lot of people were going, all I mean, I love KDA. Oh my god, it's so great! But like, like, you know, it's like the all kind of like avatar, and I think the middle ground where you're kind of doing both is just like. Like really interesting, and so few people are doing that. Even though I kind of feel like that's the future. Like I feel like people sometimes struggle with engaging entirely with, like a CG character. Mm-hmm. Although I guess KDA is like exceptionally popular. So I'm undermining my own thesis here. But yeah, I just always appreciated that you guys were like, having these two, have one foot in the digital realm so profoundly and one foot in the real world, I guess.
And we thought it was really cool because for us, we started with the metaverse thing and then went on to doing more live performances. And this was all kind of all connected with timing as well because we did debut during COVID. So it was like all of our stuff was on screen. And like even if we did film like performances, there would be no like audience.
Yeah.
So it was like we felt very... cyber, I
guess. Yeah.
And for you, it's like you started doing lives
and then went
on to doing a lot more things on the metaverse. Universe thing. And so we thought, you know, that was really cool because we are doing the same thing, but kind of opposite directions,
Yes.
We actually did hear about you from Brian once.
From Brian?
We were shooting for Next Level.
Oh. Okay.
We were talking about you, actually. Because, like, 우리 음악을 틀어줬을 때, 이분 음악을 틀어줬었잖아. 우리 냉래 자켓 찍을 때. And so they played your music while we were filming. And so we're like, oh my god, is this Grimes? And he was like, oh my god, she knows you too. And we're like, really? And then it kind of ended there. We're like, we've always had this like interest in you, and especially Ningning like really loves their music as well.
Thank you.
And so it's so cool that we can actually see you and talk about that here.
Yeah, no, it's so nice to meet you guys. Like, 그냥
이분 보고 음악이 되게 뭔가 창의적인 느낌의 곡이 되게 많은데 혹시 영감은 어디서 받는지 궁금해가지고 어디서 받나요?
I don't even know. I kind of just jam. I mean, I think mostly, I mean, I do think kind of like you guys. I'm like very interested in the interplay between technology and music. And I also, one of my favorite things that you guys do is like, it's in this like pop idol context, but there's all this sort of like high concept subtext. And I've I really like that because I really like using pop aesthetics, but like introducing more complex ideas or more sort of like radical art within that. And I think that's kind of my inspiration too. Like I really like just the euphoric gratification of pop visuals and pop music and you know, but I like just sort of like throwing in like weird things about, you know, like how you guys do with like metaverse stuff and identity and I quite relate to that philosophy or like some of my favorite lyrics, like in your song Girls, like there's just some like crazy lyrics in there, and I literally think this is just like this is gonna be a bad translation, but where we have it, okay, the algorithms that have been distorted by bad desires, or the algorithms have been distorted by bad desires. They use existence as the weapon and swallow with destruction. Evil was started at that moment. And I don't know, I was just like sort of reading translations of your lyrics preparing for this, and I was like, this is this is not normal pop lyrics.
Completely not normal lyrics.
But I love that you guys like engage with these sort of like higher context or higher concepts, but then also if you just want to come in for something beautiful and catchy, you get that too. And I think that's kind of my philosophy too. Like, I believe that art should be just fun and just beautiful and just make you feel good. But I love when it goes deeper too. Like,
Yeah.
I don't know.
Like, what you said about that is actually so cool because our whole, how do you say, 세계관? Worldview.
Yeah.
Our whole worldview actually is all about that, about good, bad. And like, if you look at our lyrics, it's literally like about being 흑화? 약간 타락 같은 거? Like, going dark. I don't know, like how evil can consume you and how we fight to stay kind or whatever. Yeah, like, if, to put it in simple words like that. But,
yeah, I mean, so one of the reasons I actually followed you guys before you debuted because I saw like Aespa with a, you know, the AE letter.
Oh, yeah.
Sort of like an ancient Germanic letter or whatever that I'm really obsessed with. It's my son's middle name.
Really?
Yeah.
That is so crazy.
아들의 그 middle 성, 중간 이름.
Yeah. And I pronounce it AI, but I liked that it was an ancient pronunciation of AI. Like, or like that I could like sort of like, I don't know, I wanted it to be this super ancient, super futuristic thing.
Wow.
And so I put this new meaning on it that, you know, wasn't its inherent meaning. And I noticed you guys kind of did the same thing. Like, you took the AE, and I forget what words you used, but, like, you just, like, totally changed the meaning so that it, like, sort of, like, represented, you know, the break between. Like, you kind of did a similar thing.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, even making it, I think, what was it? What does the A stand for?
Avatar.
It was avatar and exists.
Experience.
Yeah. And I just thought that was another strange coincidence between us, that kind of like randomly happened at the same time. But yeah, I was wondering how, I guess my question extends to, you know, how much do you feel like it's important to bring the past into the future? And do you care about language in that way? And I like the idea that you've aesthetic somehow just using letters, by pulling out this old one, you were able to like sort of like create a visual aesthetic even just to the word itself of your band name. And I thought that was really beautiful. And I'm not really sure what the question is, but just sort of how did you get there? And what does that mean to you? And I think it really helps the group stand out in a way that's, you know, interesting.
저희가 쓰는 I, 이거는 avatar and experience가 맞고, 약간 그 고대 그리스 그런 것보다는 저희가 일단 세계관 얘기 속에서 아바타들이랑 experience를 경험하면서 우리가 막 친하게도 지냈다가 걔네랑 싸우기도 했다가 이런 스토리들이 되게 많은데 그거를 한 단어로 만들기 위해서는 새로운 단어가 필요했어요. 그래가지고 이제 합성을 해가지고 AE, Avatar and Experience가 딱 그런 의미가 만들어진 것 같고 로고도 되게 예쁘게 만들어지더라고요. 그래서
Do you get any, I know this might be kind of weird, but do you get inspiration like also from the whole like from your children and from like the whole experience of that?
Oh yeah, definitely. It's been totally life-changing and art-changing. Also just because when you have kids, you have so much less time, so when I'm being creative, I feel like my mind, when I get to be creative, there's just so much more intention and focus. And almost like a moral imperative to be, I used to always make like, you know, like a lot of dark stuff. And like, it just really oriented me around like, oh no, I want to make art for a world I want to see. And I want to make art that's like more philosophical and more conceptual. And, you know, like, I especially want to make more art that like is kid accessible. I feel like in a weird way, a lot of the greatest art ever made was like randomly actually, it was like a lot of the world's greatest artists making art for children, like the Studio Ghibli, Miyazaki, and then like J.R.R. Tolkien, Lord of the Rings. It's like, if you look at a lot of the things that people like really appreciate most, like a lot of it was just them making it for their kids. And I feel sort of a moral imperative to like start convincing more artists to make stuff specifically for kids. Because also, if you don't, if you actually respect a child and what a child can actually understand, you know, you don't need to necessarily limit yourself or dumb it down.
Yeah,
like children do really appreciate beauty.
Yeah.
you know, my babies actually love K-pop.
Like, really?
They really love K-pop. And they're really obsessed with dancing, like coordinated dancing.
Wow.
Where I was like, this might, cute. I feel like this is like a universal truth that like really precise, like coordinated dancing might be something, like clearly there's just something here that like, I don't know. It's like a universal joy or something.
Universal joy.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for your next album.
Oh,
do
sweet.
You have some plans?
Spoiler.
Yeah, it's, I mean, it's been a bit crazy. It got held in limbo for a while, and then I started making a new album, but my management is killing me because they're like we have a whole album, why won't you release it? I have a bunch of stuff coming up I'm really, really excited about. It's very, very I went through this whole process of like labels and you know, there's always been a lot of like pressure to like, you know, like make the first single the most commercial thing and like all this stuff. And I feel like I'm sort of getting to a place where like I can be a lot more experimental. Mm-hmm. And I think society is coming to a place where like they're accepting more experimental music again. And so I'm really excited about that. I'm like half distracted and less focused on my album per se, because I'm really trying to like sort of focus on the singles and like focus on the videos. Mm-hmm. And I want to make an album. I'm having an AI album. I have my album and an AI album.
Oh,
and it's like I'm gonna make them compete.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I want, it's sort of like an experiment about like AI versus humanity. And so I'm working with a bunch of kids who are using various types of AI to basically in the Grimes style, and I'm like feeding them training data and like various things. So they're doing the AI thing, and they're doing all the art for it, and then I'm doing my thing, and I'm doing all the art for it. And I don't know, just want, I want to like sort of like, yeah, force them to compete. Mm-hmm. And
제가 엘프테크에 대해서 좀 설명을 들었는데 그게 너무 신기하고 되게 신박한 아이디어라고 생각을 해서 뭔가 그게 내가 부르지 않아도 이렇게 내 목소리로 노래가 하나를 만들어진다는 건데 그게 뭔가 그런 많은 데이터들을 내가 녹음을 하는 건지 아니면 어떻게 진행이 되는 건지 그게 너무 궁금했어요.
So in this instance, what we've done is we've created a voice emulator that uses AI to... So if you sang into it and you sang like la 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 la, transform, it would be my voice. And so what we're doing is we are letting kids basically make music, use my voice, and then like we're open sourcing Grimes, and then we are not punishing them for distributing that music. And in some cases, if they do it through us, we can collect royalties for them, but they're also allowed to do it through another label. And it's been a really interesting project. I'm still not sure. Part of it is experimenting because I don't know if people should be allowed to do this. I know a lot of artists find it very invasive. I think what's cool about it for me is it's really hard to break into the music industry. If someone does this with me, like we split publishing with them and we can collect their publishing and we can like pay them. Mm-hmm. And it sort of seems like the next step in fan art because I think there's so much big IP, like I always refer to League of Legends or Harry Potter as like large franchises that don't punish fan art. Like they let people, like there's so much good League of Legends art where people are selling prints of it and League of Legends is not shutting it down, or the Harry Potter fan fiction and all this stuff. And I kind of just wanted to take it to the next level. Like how do we pay fans and like of the art for making fan art basically? Mm. Like, you know, because... and building an ecosystem that is like a symbiotic artistic ecosystem.
Was there any result? Was there any of the results that you specifically liked or enjoyed listening to from that?
Yeah, no, there were some people, there's a lot of chaos, but there's some people that did better versions of things I wanted to do than I would have done. And it was sort of like almost beautiful kind of, because I was like, oh, this is so cool that I'm like, you can sort of like throw creative things into the world, and you can actually see someone take what you've done and elaborate on it and make it better. Mm-hmm. And you know, a couple of people actually got signed from the songs that they did.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah. It was really cool.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah.
That's actually so cool. You are like helping people as well.
Yeah, I think it's really hard to get attention right now in music. Super. So I feel like with indie artists, it's like sometimes it's easier to get the cosigns of like bigger artists. That does seem to be like a big thing. Mm-hmm. And I think like established artists like do owe a debt to like trying to see who's great in indie music. Mm. And you know, help those people actually get careers, because it's hard to figure out what to do, especially if you're trying to stay outside the system.
Yeah, true.
How is it working with all four of you and negotiating between all that? Like, it seems like in many ways great. Like, you know, every time I do have sort of a creative partner, it's like so fulfilling to me, but also sometimes you fight. but yeah, like what's it like working? Like, I mean, I feel like you guys are just like probably together so much of the time. Mm-hmm.
우선 저희는 되게 네 명이 성격도 다 다른데도 되게 하나로 잘 뭉쳐지는 게 있는 것 같아요. 그래서 되게 일단 사람으로도 너무 잘 맞고 We're so close friend and like family. 그래서 그냥 저희끼리 말 안 해도 통하는 게 있어서 일할 때도 되게 잘 맞는 것 같고 솔직히 다른 K-pop 뭔가 이런 걸 보면은 많이 싸우기도 하고 서로 되게 안 맞는 팀들도 많더라고요. 근데 저희는 그냥 애초에 그런 거 없이 너무 잘 맞고 항상 무슨 일이 있으면 바로바로 해결하는 스타일들이라서 그래서 되게 큰 문제 없이 원만하게 잘 활동하고 있는 것 같아요.
Very sick. Touring's hard, huh?
It's like,
yes.
It's hard. Physically, it's kind of
yeah. Physically, yeah. It's really hard. I think especially when you're supposed to maintain beauty.
Exactly.
Like, yeah.
Yeah. 뭔가 예쁜 걸 유지하려고 하는 그 빡셈.
I do think the touring really solidifies fandom. Yeah, like I do think it's hard, but it like I don't know. It puts you in people's memories for real.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah.
And yeah. I also wanted to ask like I have a couple friends in K-pop and they specifically So I love making music videos. It's one of my favorite art forms. And so, like, also when I watch music videos, I can, like, really see the effort that goes into it. Like, I know exactly, you know, yeah, like actually memorizing dances is hard. Actually doing that with, like, integrating with CG is hard. Like actually, you know. And, like, one of my friends was telling me, like, they'll shoot 3 days and you're, like, sleeping on the couch. Yeah, and it's, like, I don't know. Yeah, I just wanted to ask about the music video process because I think it's, like, one of the best things about the industry. I think you guys are like some of the people who are innovating the most in this realm. And I don't know, I feel like it's like both so difficult, but also I feel like it's a medium that America is kind of losing. Like, I feel like it's something that like, as it becomes less and less important in America, it's something that continues to innovate in Korea. Yeah. And I'm curious, like, why do you think that is? And like, are you happy that it's so hard? And like, I don't know, like I appreciate some like that it's being kept alive and still innovated in because I think it's a
뭔가 사실 K-pop이라는 게 되게 듣는 것도 중요하지만 보이는 것도 되게 중요한 음악이라고 생각을 해서 음악도 정말 중요하지만 그런 뮤직비디오를 통해서 전달해주는 그런 메시지 같은 것도 되게 중요하게 생각을 해서 뮤직비디오를 음악만큼 되게 잘 뭔가 집중해서 찍는 편인 것 같아요. 그래서 좀 힘들고 되게 신중하게 되게 여러 사람들이 같이 의논을 해서 찍는 그런 것 같아요.
What we say in Korean a lot is 보이는 음악. So it's like music that you see.
Yeah.
So it's not only about the music, but it's also about like a person is not fully getting the K-pop experience if they don't watch the music video.
Yeah.
So it is a very
okay.
Very
I'm glad to hear that because I've always been like I feel like this is an audiovisual medium,
for sure.
And I feel like people see it the same as music. Like just regular pop music in the US, and I'm like, I feel like there's something fundamentally different here.
Yeah,
like I just feel like I've seen actually so much cinematic innovation in K-pop. Like, what are you most excited for looking into the future?
Very hard question. I'll just talk about what is most in the nearest future is we're coming out with a new song called Better Things. And I feel like you would really like the concept, actually. It's very
tropical.
Yeah, tropical, and kind of like our jacket, our teaser photos have like a lot of CG and
artwork,
colorful like things mixed in it. And the moment we saw it, we were like, oh my god, this is like so Grimes.
Sick,
and so
sick.
Yeah, it's a type of song, a type of genre that we actually haven't really shown before.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So we're kind of excited about how people would take it.
I think people really like it when the more divergence I'm seeing in the K-pop scene, when people are kind of like leaving like some of the more traditional sounds. Like, I really like it personally.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. What music do you guys listen to? How do you discover new music?
Oh, for me, I really love techno.
Me too.
Yeah.
I love techno.
So I really love your music.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, it's, you know, sci-fi and like futurist. So techno and R&B. Mm. Yeah, R&B.
What's your favorite techno right now?
Grimes.
Oh. Hey.
And yeah.
저는 주로 조금 되게 많은 여러 장르를 듣긴 하는데 되게 한국 옛날 느낌의 노래도 많이 듣고 밴드 느낌의 노래도 되게 좋아해서 그런 노래를 좀 주로 듣는 것 같아요.
I'm like an old school K-pop fan. Like I'm like, yeah.
Oh my god, me too. Yeah. I love old school K-pop.
Yeah. I still think like my allegiance to G-Dragon and Top is very, very real. And I actually knew CL a long time ago for like a while.
Oh, yeah.
She was like working with my friends.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, actually one of the beginning things of Grimes is I was like, so obsessed with K-pop music videos that's kind of what got me into directing music videos, actually, because I was like, the West just doesn't care anymore about music videos. And, you know, as we spoke, like, it just seems like such a core value in this music scene. Mm-hmm. And I don't know. I was really into, do people call that like first wave K-pop?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
And this is like fourth wave K-pop.
Yeah, first generation.
Yeah. And then also one of my friends was working with CL, so then I got like sort of dig deep into that. But I mean, how did you guys find out about me? And I think from my friend Brian. So nepotism. But
nepotism. Actually, no, because we already knew about you.
Okay.
That's why when Brian played your music, we were like, oh, that is Grimes. But
I was like slightly worried it's a one-sided relationship. I was like, do they know who I am?
No.
That's nice.
We used to say to our management as well at that time during next, we were like, we want to like do something with her. And then we never heard anything back. And so I think like, yeah, we've always had like a lot of interest in you.
Yeah, same. Yeah, this is an honor and very exciting. And yeah.
Us too.